a replication study disproves another previous aldehyde study. So a couple of months ago, Dr. Konstantinos Varsalinos set out to replicate the infamous hidden formaldehyde study published by the New England Journal of Medicine. He replicated it exactly, and as expected, found that the results were not accurate because the researchers vaped the devices at unrealistic temperatures and were getting dry hits, which no person would do on purpose. The hidden formaldehyde study came out in January 2015, then another similar study came out in July 2016, which claimed that increasing voltage on a single coil device from 3.3 volts to 4.8, aldehyde emissions tripled from 53 to 165 micrograms per puff, and the aldehydes increased by more than 60% after the devices were reused. They concluded that this was due to byproduct buildup in the atomizer that degraded when it was heated. They also claimed that acrolein rates grew by a factor of 10. Aldehydes and acrolein are carcinogens, so obviously the results of this study were scary news for vapors, but after digging into the testing methods, it was pretty obvious that these researchers made the same mistakes as the researchers from the hidden formaldehyde study did. And they burned the wicks and were testing on dry hits. So the 2016 study is the main focus today. Dr. Varsalinos has performed a replication study on this 2016 study and just published the results. His team used the same equipment, power settings, and puff duration. They used a CE4 atomizer at 3.8 volts and 4.8 volts with 5-second puffs. First, as was expected, the cause of aldehyde emissions were caused by dry puffs, which is not a realistic way to vape. Second, Varsalinos' team found 6 to 25 times lower aldehyde levels even in dry puff conditions, so that original research was grossly exaggerated. And third, newer equipment has totally different results. So in addition to replicating the original study, he also added in a test on the Nautilus Mini, which is a really old tank in the vape world, but still accurate for this test since it's a newer generation product that uses cotton wicks. On this test, they found that aldehyde emissions were so low that vaping 5 mils of e-juice per day would still produce 94 to 99.8% lower aldehyde levels than smoking 20 cigarettes. That's a huge difference and shows just how little harm is being caused by vaping, at least in relation to smoking. So there you go, another great study from Dr. Varsalinos showing how previous studies used incorrect methodology to get negative results.